James Oliver passed a lie detector test. Man who claims he's a time traveler from year 6491 but stuck in 2018 passes lie detector test. James Oliver says he is stuck in our time zone after his time machine broke, but a paranormal expert claims he is telling the truth. A time traveler who claims he is stuck in the year 2018 because his time machine broke has reportedly passed a lie detector test. James Oliver says he was on a mission in the 21st century from the year 6491, but is unable to get home to his family and friends. It sounds like something straight out of the plot of one of the Back to the Future films, but now there is evidence he may be telling the truth. Paranormal YouTube site ApexTV hooked him up to a lie detector test and claims he passed every question. His face is blurred out and his accent is a thick Birmingham one, which can sometimes sound American or Australian, and he has a slight lisp. "Your years are different to mine," he tells the presenter, whose face has also been blurred out. There is some obscurity as to whether he lives on planet Earth or another planet, as he adds, "Where I'm from, the years are longer. My planet is further away from the sun than yours is, so it takes longer to get around. But we have gifted mathematicians who work to calculate our years from those from other civilizations." But he does, however, appear to be human. When he has finished speaking, the word "true" appears on the screen over the video, but the camera never pans to the laptop to prove he is not lying. He says global warming is going to get worse and our planet is going to get hotter, and advises us to put a cap on carbon emissions. He goes on to say that everyone in the future has their own artificial intelligence system called Siri, which recognizes users by their voice. He adds, "We are constantly finding new planets and galaxies every day. Most of it is just nothing. Sometimes you hit the jackpot and find intelligent life on it. You find new planets, new ecosystems. There are a lot of planets more intelligent than humans. Planets are controlled by an umbrella of elected officials, similar to the United Nations, but all still have some independent control." When asked if there has been fights between humans and aliens, he says, "I can apostrophe T dot 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 yes," seemingly stuttering. But he then finds his confidence, adding, "There have been some conflicts, but most of it has been put under control by the Federation very quickly. The Federation is there as a peacekeeping vessel." He claims to work for an alien research agency, specializing in the history and culture of the human race. When asked if he has ever met an alien, he replies, "Personally, several times. The definition of alien is something out of this world, so technically, I am meeting one right now. I have, on occasion. But the only time I meet them is when I am at home. It's the same sort of thing. They travel to where I live and I do know them. I have personal relationships with a few of them. I have friends I'd consider aliens. They are a nice lot, they are. Don't be quick to judge. I have some who are quite good friends. My closest friend is from another galaxy." Turning somber, he admits he misses his family and friends the most, and that he doesn't know when he was maybe rescued. The interviewer then asks who the future US presidents are, but he says he cannot disclose this. "But your superiors are okay with you talking with us?" he queries. "Yes," James replies. "I can communicate with subjects, but there is a restriction as to what I can tell you." His story echoes the Back to the Future storyline, where Marty McFly gets stuck in the 50s because his time machine, an old DeLorean, runs out of plutonium.